Bloemfontein. Bloemfontein is the capital city of the province of Free State of South Africa, and, as the judicial capital of the nation, one of South Africa's three national capitals and is the seventh largest city in South Africa. Situated at an altitude of above sea level, the city is home to approximately 520,000 residents and forms part of the Mongong Metropolitan Municipality, which has a population of 747,431. The city of Bloemfontein hosts the Supreme Court of Appeal of South Africa, the Franklin Game Reserve, the Mosselspoort Resort and the city hosts numerous museums, including the National Women's Monument, the Anglo-Boer War Museum, the National Museum, and the Olyan Hughes Art Museum. Bloemfontein also hosts Sub-Saharan Africa's first digital planetarium, the Naval Hill Planetarium and Boyden Observatory, an astronomical research observatory erected by Harvard University. Bloemfontein is popularly and poetically known as the City of Roses, for its abundance of these flowers and the annual Rose Festival held there. The city's Sesotho name is Mongong, meaning place of cheetahs. The origin of the city's name is disputed. It is likely borrowed from the Dutch words Bloemenfontein, meaning fountain of flowers. Popular legends include an ox named Bloem owned by Rudolphus Martinus Brits, one of the pioneer farmers that was taken by a lion near a fountain on his property, while another story names Jan Bloem, a Karana Khoikhoi leader who settled there. Though historically a predominantly Afrikaner settlement, Bloemfontein was officially founded in 1846 as a fort by British Army Major Henry Douglas Wardeen as a British outpost in the Transoranje region, at that stage occupied by various groups of peoples including Cape Colony Trek Boers, Griqua, and Barolong. Wardeen originally chose the site largely because of its proximity to the main route to Windhoek, the spacious open country, and the absence of horse sickness. Bloemfontein was the original farm of Johannes Nicolaas Brits, born February 21, 1790, owner and first inhabitant of Bloemfontein. Johan, as he was known, sold the farm to Major Wardeen. With colonial policy shifts, the region changed into the Orange River Sovereignty and eventually the Orange Free State Republic. From 1902-10 it served as the capital of the Orange River Colony and since that time as the provincial capital of the Free State. In 1910 it became the judicial capital of the Union of South Africa. The Orange Free State was an independent Boer sovereign republic in southern Africa during the second half of the 19th century. Extending between the Orange and Vaal rivers, its borders were determined by the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland in 1848 when the region was proclaimed as the Orange River Sovereignty, with a seat of a British resident in Bloemfontein. As the capital of the Orange Free State Republic, the growth and maturing of the republic resulted in the growth of Bloemfontein. Numerous public buildings that remain in use today were constructed. This was largely facilitated by the excellent governance of the republic and the compensation from the British for the loss of the diamond-rich Griqualand area. The old Orange Free State's presidential residency, the Old Presidency, is currently a museum and cultural space in the city. A railway line was built in 1890 connecting Bloemfontein to Cape Town. The writer J.R.R. Tolkien was born in the city on January 3, 1892, though his family left South Africa following the death of his father, Arthur Tolkien, while Tolkien was only three. He recorded that his earliest memories were of a hot country. In 1899 the city was the site of the Bloemfontein Conference, which failed to prevent the outbreak of the Second Boer War. The conference was a final attempt to avert a war between Britain and the South African Republic. With its failure the stage was set for war, which broke out on October 11, 1899. The rail line from Cape Town provided a centrally located railway station, and proved critical to the British in occupying the city later. On March 13, 1900, following the Battle of Paardeberg, British forces captured the city and built a concentration camp nearby to house Boer women and children. The National Women's Monument, on the outskirts of the city, pays homage to the 26,370 women and children as well as 1,421 old men who died in these camps in various parts of the country. The hill in town was named Naval Hill after the naval guns brought in by the British in order to fortify the position against attack. On May 31, 1910, exactly 8 years after the Boers signed the peace treaty of Vereeniging that ended the Anglo-Boer War between the British Empire and two Boer states, the South African Republic and the Orange Free State, South Africa became a union. Due to disagreements over where the union's capital should be, a compromise was reached that allowed Bloemfontein to host appellate division and become the union's judicial capital. Bloemfontein was also given financial compensation. On January 8, 1912, the South African Native National Congress was founded in Bloemfontein. The Union of South Africa had not granted rights to black South Africans, causing the organization's creation. Its primary aim was to fight for the rights of black South Africans. From 1 to January 9, 1914, James Barry Monique Herzog and his supporters met in Bloemfontein to form the National Party of the Orange Free State, and to lay down its principles, following Herzog's exit from the South African Party in 1913. The National Party grew to govern South Africa in 1948 and implement the policy of racial segregation known as apartheid. When the National Party won the 1948 South African national government elections, they began implementing the policy known as apartheid. The policy was built on white supremacy and racial segregation was implemented. In Bloemfontein, residential segregation had begun in the 19th century with the passing of Ordinance 1 of 1860, which determined that no non-white, without written permission from the landlord, had the right to occupy urban land in towns where local municipalities did not yet exist. On June 3, 1861, the council demarcated three locations in the following areas. The black population was to move to the area which lied to the right of a neighborhood that was known as Kafferfontein. Coloreds were to move to the Wyhoek black residential area on the eastern outskirts of the town. The inhabitants of these settlements had to pay taxes, the so-called hut tax, as well as tax on grazing rights. This laid the foundation for the implementation of residential urban segregation as envisaged by the architects of apartheid. When the South African apartheid government passed the Group Areas Act of 1950, the Bloemfontein municipality put into effect changes in the racial set-up of the city. The municipality demolished the Cape Stans residential area, which was occupied by the city's colored population, and moved the residents to Heidel. However, due to coloreds living in such close proximity with black people, intermarriages across racial lines occurred, resulting in a partial mixed population in Heidel and Mongluang. In 1952, the Bloemfontein municipality began building new residential areas for the city's black population. New residential areas to separate ethnic groups such as Sotho, Xhosa and Tswana were formed. The residential areas were jointly known as Mongong. Fayamang, a Sotho township, was the first formal housing projects to be approved by the municipality in 1956. Physical buffers such as the railway line and roads were put into place to separate black ethnic groups, the white and colored population. 11,000 housing structures, of which approximately 6,000 were government-built rental accommodation, were erected in Mongong between 1952 to 1968. In 1968, Mongong faced serious housing shortages when as much as 3,000 to 6,000 housing units were needed. To counter this problem, a 55 kilometers eastward expansion called Botsabelo was added in 1979. The Bloemfontein municipality channeled of all black urbanization to Thaba Enchu and Botsabelo. Botsabelo was developed as source of cheap labor for the city of Bloemfontein. A subsidized bus service was established, and Botsabelo was declared decentralization point. This means that Botsabelo was to become an industrial development point in order to reduce the distance between place of employment and place of residence. In 1988, an approximate 14,500 people were commuting on a daily basis between Botsabelo and Bloemfontein. This meant that 55% of Botsabelo's workforce was employed outside the city. In 1994, after the disestablishment of the apartheid government, Bloemfontein, Botsabelo, and Thaba Enchu became part of Motheo District Municipality. The Motheo District Municipality was disestablished on May 18, 2011, and Mongong was upgraded to become an autonomous metropolitan municipality with Bloemfontein as the main seat. Until 1994, the city was the sole judicial capital of South Africa. It remains the seat for the Supreme Court of Appeal. It is also an administrative center with many private hospitals and educational institutions. Free State Provincial Government Building. Bloemfontein forms part of the Mongong Metropolitan Municipality, which was upgraded from a local municipality in 2011. The Mongong Metropolitan Municipality elects a municipal council for five-year periods, through a mixed-member proportional representation system in which wards elect individual councillors alongside those named from party lists. Voters get two votes, one for a representative to become a ward councillor and the other for a political party. The latter vote is used to distribute seats in the municipal council amongst parties, while the former distributes seats through individual representatives. The current executive mayor of Mongong, Alin Layemalili, was elected in August 2016. Bloemfontein is located in central South Africa on the southern edge of the High Veld at an elevation of, bordering on the semi-arid region of the Karoo. The area is generally flat with occasional hills and the general vegetation is high veld grassland. Bloemfontein experiences a semi-arid climate, with hot summer days and cooler, dry winters, often with frost. Snow is rare, but as recently as August 2006 it snowed in the city, with snowfalls occurring again at the airport on July 26, 2007. Bloemfontein suburbs include Heidel to the east and southeast, Bainsfley, Woodland Hills Wildlife Estate, Brandvak, Ehrlich Park, Fauna, Fitchart Park, Floridal, Gardenia Park, General de Wet, Hospital Park, Key Purcell, Laurier Park, Park West, Pelissier, Uitzig, Universitas, Westdene, Wilgehoff and Willows to the south of the city. To the west of Bloemfontein, you will find Langenhoven Park. To the north you will find Arboretum, Base Valley, Basewater, Dan Pienaar, Helicon Heights, Huelsig, Hillsborough, Hillside, Hilton, Naval Hill, Navelsig, Nurithuk, Pentagon Park, Panorama Park, and Waverley. To the northeast you will find Rudul and Vallambrosa. The predominantly black suburbs are Rocklands, Famang, Falindaba, Bloemanda, Bokabela, and the most historic Bato, where the Mafikila House is situated. The Free State Stadium and the surrounding sports complex is the main sports venue in the city and province. The venue was the hosting stadium of the 2010 FIFA World Cup South Africa matches played in Bloemfontein. There are several other sports venues in the city, however, including facilities belonging to the university, schools and sports clubs. Other stadiums in the city is Mongong Oval, Dr. Petrus Malemela Stadium and Clive Solomon Stadium. Bloemfontein is joined home to Premier Soccer League team Bloemfontein Celtic. Some of the matches of the 2010 FIFA World Cup were played at the Free State Stadium, including the historic 4-1 defeat of England by Germany in the round of 16. Bloemfontein's Free State Stadium is home to two rugby union teams, the Cheetahs, who compete in the Pro 14, and the Free State Cheetahs, who play in the domestic Currie Cup. The Free State Cheetahs won the Currie Cup in 2005 against the Blue Bulls. They drew the final with the Blue Bulls in 2006 and retained the Currie Cup title in 2007 by beating the Golden Lions, resulting in the Cheetahs remaining Currie Cup champions until 2008, when they failed to make the final for the first time since 2004. 2009 saw the Cheetahs return to the Currie Cup final, but they were unable to beat the Blue Bulls at Loftus-Versfeld. In 2016 the Cheetahs won the Currie Cup after a perfect season, beating the Blue Bulls at home in Bloemfontein. The Knights cricket team representing the Free State and Northern Cape in various series is located at Mongong Oval, part of the Free State Stadium complex. Bloemfontein features as a regular venue for touring international and local cricket teams. The town has one of the most active soaring communities in South Africa and the world, using the new Tempe Airport, north of Bloemfontein. Bloemfontein has a motocross track run by the Bloemfontein Off-Road Club, as well as a go-kart circuit, which was closed down in early 2015. Bloemfontein has a comprehensive shooting center south of the city, offering most forms of shooting, including various clay target, pistol and rifle disciplines. Bloemfontein shooting sport community has produced many provincial and national representatives over the years. Bloemfontein has two rock climbing clubs, each with a wall and boulder cave. Every year Bloemfontein, the City of Roses, celebrates the Bloemfontein Rose Festival, known also as the Mongong Rose Festival, in October, the cool month in which roses in the Free State bloom best. The majority of the events happen at the Loch Logan waterfront in Bloemfontein. The festival attracts rose enthusiasts from all over South Africa and the world to participate in and experience this grand showcase of roses and other local events and attractions. The festival has made Bloemfontein a popular tourist destination, as thousands of people attend the festival annually. The first Rose Festival first took place in 1976, when council members decided that hosting such a festival was appropriate, given the area's name. In 1976 the events spanned over a few days and included activities related to roses in the Sanlam Plaza. Since then, the Rose Festival has expanded and grown to meet the needs and interests of the public. Horticulturalists are invited to take part in competitions that focus on designing and improving unkempt gardens around the city. Festival activities take place in private gardens all over Bloemfontein, as local residents of the city open their gardens to the general public. Most festival activities take place at the Loch Logan waterfront, the largest shopping center in central South Africa. It spans about 80 plus 000 square meter of space and is hub of shopping, entertainment, Sport and Culture in Bloemfontein. The waterfront displays flowers created by local nurseries as well as the official municipal display created by the Parks Department, which is organized by the Mongong Municipality. The Free State Rose Society's Champion Rose Cup competition, with approximately 700 entrants every year, is also hosted at the waterfront, along with the Miss Volksblad Rosebud competition for girls aged 3 to 4 years old, organized in conjunction with the Volksblad daily newspaper. The Rose Morning High Tea usually occurs at the Earth Garden Center where tea and treats are served. The Earth Garden Center is a retail and wholesale nursery that is located on Kenneth Kaunda Road in Bloemfontein. The crowning of the King and of Mongong in the year of nomination. The Mongong Rose Classic Cycle Tour is a road race that happens during the festival every year. The event is organized by Off-Free Cycle Tours and the dates area announced annually. The race starts at the Earth and the race distances include 22 kilometers, 56 kilometers and 106 kilometers. This expo forms part of the Mongong / Bloemfontein Rose Festival and gives green and organic local businesses an opportunity to promote their businesses. This includes showcasing different products and services that support a green environment, such as solar power, grey water systems, vegetable tunnels, jojo tank systems, etc. Bloemfontein houses many institutions of learning, from preschools to universities and colleges. Classes are taught in different languages from school to school, with some schools even teaching all their classes in two languages. The languages are predominantly Afrikaans, English, and Sesotho. Bloemfontein's economy is driven by the government sector. Some of South Africa's largest retail companies have headquarters located in the city. Queen of Roses also happens during this event. The competition recognizes citizens of the city of Bloemfontein for contributions that go beyond their normal duties to enrich the Mongong Metro. Nominees need to be citizens. The largest tertiary institutions in Bloemfontein are the University of the Free State and the Central University of Technology. There is a further education and training college called Motheo Fet College, which comprises three main campuses and the satellite campuses in Zastrin, Philippolis, and Botshabelo. Some major national private educational brands maintain a presence in Bloemfontein, namely, buildings in the CBD also host smaller upstart colleges, which come and go. Such colleges catch the overflow from public institutions and late enrollments, or learners whose high school achievement may fall short of various entry requirements. This list may vary from year to year. Bloemfontein's national and regional roads are as follows: the N1, a major highway running roughly SE to NW from Cape Town to Johannesburg and Zimbabwe, largely bypasses the city to the west. The N8 runs east/west, connecting Bloemfontein to Kimberley and Maseru, the capital of Lesotho. Bloemfontein is also the northern end of the N6 road heading roughly southwards to the port of East London. At a T-junction just before the city, the N6 becomes the N30, and the intersecting road is designated the N6. This road ends in an interchange with the N1. There are also two two-digit R routes, the R64, which is the old road to Kimberley, via Dealesville and Boshoff. It ends at the N1. The R30 ends at the N1 north of the town. It is the road to Velkom. Three other three-digit R routes have their origin in Bloemfontein. The R706 takes origin from the N8 in the city center, and heads southeast towards Jagersfontein and Forsmith. The R702 also originates from the N8 in the city center, but heads southwest towards the towns of Duisdorp and Wepener. The third road, the R700, starts south of the city center from the M30 and heads north crossing the N8 and N1 towards Bultfontein. Below that level, Bloemfontein has a number of metropolitan or M roads. These roads are numbered independently of M roads in other South African cities. Bloemfontein is well connected with rail. It is located on the most important rail junction between Johannesburg and Cape Town, with daily trains to Port Elizabeth, East London, and Johannesburg. Bloemfontein has two airports: New Tempe Aerodrome and Bram Fischer International Airport. New Tempe Aerodrome has no scheduled flights, it is used as a training facility for aviators and schools. Bram Fischer International Airport has scheduled flights to all South Africa's major cities. In October 2016, the Mongong Metropolitan and various taxi associations reached an agreement on the integrated public transport system, which is currently under construction. The project consists of two phases. The first phase will see the construction of busways along the metropolitan. The second will be the building of depot and stations. Many famous people are associated with Bloemfontein. These include Bloemfontein has a large and diverse Christian population. The city houses several churches and denominations. The city also has a large Jewish population, which was established during the mid-19th century. There are two main cemeteries in Bloemfontein. On October 7, 2010, several tombstones in the Jewish cemetery in Bloemfontein were defaced with swastikas and anti-Semitic graffiti. On April 10, 2012, Bloemfontein's historic Memoriam Cemetery was vandalized, with 35 tombstones toppled and obscene graffiti daubed on the walls of the adjoining Ohel. The graffiti included images of money bags and diamonds, as well as of a crudely drawn Megan David, allegedly as part of an anti-Semitic act. There is also the old Vayamang Cemetery, which dates back to the 1960s and was specifically reserved for Africans during the apartheid era and has a hero's acre, where freedom fighters are laid to rest. The Heidi Heid Cemetery in Heidel was reserved for colored people during the apartheid era, but all races could bury their dead after 1994. This cemetery has been closed due to it being full. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.